Hello and welcome to part 7 of the tutorials video for World of Warplanes. Okay. Thought the video wouldn't start. Okay, yeah, heavy fighters. How do you play a heavy fighter? Okay, first of all, what are the characteristics of a heavy fighter? Heavy fighters are pretty not really maneuverable, so avoid dogfights with normal fighters or multi-roles. Second of all, they are decentish fast, I would say. Especially in the higher tiers, it's getting the difference between fighters and heavy fighters' speed and altitude is definitely larger than on the lower tiers. What's also noticeable is that you have a really long boost. Here it's 25 seconds, and yeah, sometimes some of the heavy fighters also have like some ground pound armament. I have now 4 250 kilogram or LB bombs, whatever LB means. I don't know. It's, I think, the English version of like the 250 kilogram bombs. Alright, first of all, I'm engaging here the airfield. The middle is also important because it's a mining plan, but we want to get control at least of one. The reason I'm playing here a bit like not going in and avoid turn fighting is that there is literally no real fighter around. Heavy fighters is not such a big problem. This guy is just running. He's going out of the cap, so I won't achieve anything by hunting him down. Other than just end up in the next cap, but I want to flip this one. So I'm going for the air defense planes. The firepower, of course, is extremely good. This one has also a rear gunner, which is also pretty nice. It's, by the way, the tier 4 British heavy fighter, the Blenheim F. And yeah, we flip it. Perfect. So always have a look at what planes you are facing in the caps you are approaching. Normally you can go... I'm not using the speed boost now. I'm using the speed boost mostly to disengage. Here I see 3 ground attackers and 1 fighter. So I'm going... or in the multi-role, it's, I think, the Hurricane. I'm immediately going for the multi-role because... whatever he did was not the smartest move. He did break away, but way too late, and that costs him his life. And now I don't mind turning and turn because there are only ground attacks. Now I'm dropping my bombs. 1, 2, 3 on this ground target, and one more for this one. And still there are only crown targets, so I can be pretty safe. Okay, there's one Hurricane, but he's almost dead, so I'm trying to finish him. That should flip the cap for us. My aim not on point, but okay. Alright, so we have our mining plan secured, we have an airfield secured, and now you can just farm what's coming in. Because they need to retake it to win the game, actually. But they didn't even achieve to... get their forward airstrip, what they achieved now, and yeah. Alright, so I'm basically just flying into or through the cap, damaging or killing whatever is there. It's a bit like Boom and Zoom. The Boom and Zoom fighter video will be coming after this one, but it's literally a bit Boom and Zoom. You don't want to stay in the cap and like fight with fighters. You just damage them, or when it's safe, you can do it, of course. Yeah, this is what I'm afraid of, the fighter that is hunting me, but it doesn't matter. Because I have my speed boost available and can speed away. Of course, that's not always possible, but because if you have like a fighter that came from above, he has a lot of energy and also a lot of speed. Yeah, that you might not be able to outrun him, but that's the rare case. Also, you want to be at high altitude with your with your heavy, but I'm playing it here on low because there's nothing really high in the air, and yeah, it's all pretty safe for me, I would say. Defending the airfield and gaining some altitude. The reason I was looking there is it an airfield? Can I repair? But no, that's not an airfield. So I'm gaining some altitude to have some more energy, because you always want to maintain your energy. So means the perfect thing would be you are above every other plane that is like or can engage you in a dogfight or whatever. Exceptions are bombers normally, but it's not often the case. So I think a good altitude is like, for this one here, 1500 meters. Of course you can go higher, and but it's not necessary, because in this low tiers most of the fights are in this low till medium altitude, so not too high. Yeah, try to eliminate the bomber, but sadly I'm not really my damage isn't that great, it looks like. I think the German tier 4 heavy, for example, is a bit stronger in that regard, but it doesn't have the ground pound capabilities, for example. It has only two bombs, and this one has four bombs. But that's kind of a pattern. The Germans are getting faster, the British get more ground pound capabilities. That's kind of the traits of the lines. But they are, yeah, both pretty fine. Yeah, there's a heavy fighter, try to finish him. Not going to happen, because I'm unlucky, whatever. But it's from front, so never do easy. Snapshotting the crown attacker there. And again, I don't mind like slowing down even to shoot him down, because there's literally no fighter threat for me here. And when it is, I'm just speeding away. And I have my rear gunner that can also protect and inflict some damage on the fighters. Of course, the rear gunner is only effective against fighters, not against heavy fighters. Heavy fighters will just melt you. That's the biggest concern you have to have. Yeah. Hope it showed you how to do it in a heavy fighter. If you have some further questions, just write it in the comments below. Otherwise, I wish you a good day, and see you to the next tutorial video, I think tomorrow. So, bye-bye.